Okay, it's Heather again at the Craft Shack. I am going to try something fun today and see how we like it. I've already done a few samples and learned a few things. I got this idea from Inky Smiles. Erin Grodeget over at Inky Smiles does a lot of tutorials, and she's got a great picture tutorial on this technique, but I wanted to give it a try, and I'm glad that I did because I figured out a few things while I was doing it. So, items that you'll need are toilet paper, some water. I just have a little bottle filled with some water, and a detailed stamp. Now, this stamp that I have is from Close to My Heart. Excuse me. Close to My Heart, Happy Journey is the name of that stamp set. And it's this big medallion stamp here. And it looks like it's going to have a lot of detail, but it's not very deeply cut. So this isn't the best example to use, but it's going to give us a pretty neat effect. And then at the end of the video, I'll show you some other ideas that I did using totally different stamps. So let's go ahead and get going on this one. The first thing you want to do is, this was a tip that I figured out along the process. I have made, it looks like 12 of these so far. And out of the 12 that I've done, the best one was where I separated the two-ply. I have two-ply toilet paper. I don't think it really matters, but this is Quilted Northern. And not that that matters that you use one or the other, but I did find that separating the sheets myself was better, because otherwise I had an example where the sheets kind of separated on their own as I took them out of the mold. So you don't want that. So what you do want to do is layer. I'm going to take one full piece and just put it over the entire image, and then after that I'm going to overlap each of these different and I don't know why my toilet paper doesn't want to rip right there. It's like it didn't get the perforations, I guess they're called. It didn't get perforated at the factory very well, so hopefully yours isn't quite such a problem. There's different ways, different things that you can do. I'm just going to show you the white version, because this is pretty, this molded paper technique it's usually done in white, so we'll see it in white, and then I'll show you some colored versions that I did on my own using some Lindy's Stamp Gang Starburst sprays. So alright, so just kind of giving it some layers, and I am extending beyond because I do want to be able to tear off some of those edges to give it that frayed look that it's going to have. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to want to do is spray it with the bottle of water. You can run it under the sink, I guess, but this is the only way I've done it. So what's also nice is if you reuse your Bath & Body Works body spray, travel size body spray, then it has a nice fragrance. So get it nice and wet. Okay, good. Very wet. Very wet. Alright, so now what I'm going to do with my flat hand is kind of press that toilet paper down into the mold, into the stamp, which is now my mold. And I'm going to go along the edges and just kind of push towards the middle, defining that edge really well. And then I'm going to push that edge down. I'm going to do this all the way around. And I am noticing that it's not quite wet enough on the edges, so I'm just going to spritz it again. Alright, and pushing in towards the middle, just ever so slightly. I mean, it's not a big deal. It's just I'm trying to get this excess stuff over here onto the mold, and then squeezing out the liquid. So I'm just going to keep doing this all the way around. And yeah, I'm going to do that other side because I sprayed it with water again. So let's keep doing that until I have a definite edge that I want. I want that edge defined because that, you know, mimics the mold. So, okay. All right, now with my fingers, I'm just going to press into that design as much as I can. This isn't very hard. I will tell you, this particular project is a little messy. It's a lot of fun, a little messy, and you're going to get a great result at the end, but you do need patience. I don't have very many patients, so this was kind of a tough one for me, but the point is, you want to be able to see the mold, the stamped image. You want to be able to see that image on the other side of this. So what we're going to do now is tear off the edges here. And why do you need patience? That's where I was going with my thought process. Why do you need patience? Well, you'll see in a minute after I get to this point of drying. The drying process takes quite a bit, and even using my heating emboss gun, whatever that thing is called, even using that, it took a long time. So, all right, the next thing is I just took a wad of paper towel or toilet paper right off the thing and kind of wad it up, so I have this wad, and then press it down. This part is actually more important than I thought it was. You really need to press it down. And this is very wet now, so I'm just going to go ahead and get myself another drier area and just press it down into that stamped image, trying to bring those details out. The more you press it, the more water, excess water you bring out of the paper, which is going to help with that patience part I was just talking about. But also, it also gets more detail onto the paper from your stamp. And if you have a poor detail stamp like I do, it's not very deep. That's what I mean by poor detail. It's got lots of detail. I mean, just take a look at that. It's got lots of detail. However, it's not very deeply cut. This particular stamp isn't. So, not a lot of grooves and, you know, valleys for the paper towel to go hide in. Get pushed into. So this part is really important to make sure you get a really good detailed image when we're all done. It also helps to not have as much to dry. So I think that should do it. Okay, so now what we're going to do is go ahead and dry it using my heat gun. And this part might be kind of loud, so I'm not sure if you'll be able to hear me or not, but I'm actually probably going to speed this up on the video so it doesn't take as long. And I'll let you know how long it takes in real time. Let's go ahead and do it. Oh, and you do want to stay about 6 to 8 inches away and kind of keep it moving, or you will burn the toilet paper. I have actually done that. I caught it on fire. I'm like, some smells like it's burning. You'll know when it's dry because it will become more opaque than translucent. When the toilet paper is wet, it's kind of see-through. And as you dry it, it becomes more and more opaque. And as you get closer to the end of the drying time, you can lift up a corner, and if it easily pops off, then it's dry. If it's still stuck to the stamp, it's not ready yet. So the edges came up okay, but I'm not sure if the whole thing is dry yet. No, it's still kind of a little bit wet, not very much. All right, now you can kind of tell it is still just a tiny bit damp. Excuse me, something in my throat. It is still just a tiny bit damp, but you can see the image is in there, and I don't want us to wreck it. Now you can spritz it with shimmer mists or whatever. You could do that afterwards if you have just a really quick drying. It won't hurt it too bad. Let me show you some examples. Here is one that I did when I finally figured out what not to do, I guess. So I don't know if you can see the detail in that or not, but here is another one where I realized that this, I think I showed you this one earlier, I realized that the two ply is coming apart from the other ply, so it did this just all on its own, and that really aggravated me, but I started to figure it out. Now, this one I made using paper towel instead. And what I did first was I spritzed it with some Lindy Stamp Gang Moon Shadow Mist. This one here is called Bucket of Blood Red. And that's what gives it that walnut brown. It's a moon shadow, so it has that walnut ink in it, and then that red shimmery comes from the wonderful people at Lindy Stamp Gang. They make these awesome sprays. But anyway, I did that first. I sprayed it with that first and dried it, then put it onto the stamp and went through that whole process I just showed you. So that's how I received that one. And then utilizing some different stamps, this sunflower is from Something Splendid stamp set, and I just used the detailed part with the center and everything, and it's actually black because I've used stays on. That has nothing to do with this project. And then I used the leaves, and I created this one here, and you can kind of see that I colored it utilizing, I made my own ink, a spray using alcohol ink from Tim Holtz. This one's called Butterscotch. I wanted that yellow for the sunflower, and I just put it into a empty bottle I had with some hot water and some Create a Shade pearl paint, and that created this spray. And what I did was sprayed it and then attached it to this. I realized later I should have dried it first, because it just stuck to the thing. But anyway, there's that. And then I did the leaves, and this is still just kind of a little bit damp. I was afraid to do it anymore because I thought I was going to lose the detail, because I don't know if you can see or not, but the detail of this is not, it's there, but I didn't know how it would show up on paper towel. And so here I had sprayed with the Starburst spray, this one called Cement Green from Lindy Stamp Gang, and I just lightly sprayed it and then put it on and went through the whole process I just showed you. And that's going to look great on a card, I think. All right, and then finally my favorite is what if you don't have, you know, a medallion stamp or a deep cut flower. Well, I thought this actually would be really neat to do if I took my the stamp set is called Cherished Flourishes, and I don't know if this one's still available or not. I don't remember seeing it, but anyway, something with all these swirls and stuff would work great. You don't have to have this stamp set. But I just placed each of the items in a pattern so that it looked like, you know, a really and because they're individually stamped, it's very deep cut, so you've got lots of detail to work with. And then I really wanted it, the reason why it's purple is because using Lindy Stamp Gang Starbursts, both of these, okay, make a mess, sorry, using both of these, Jazzy Jive in Purple and French Lilac Violet, these two I sprayed in just on the paper itself, and then placed that paper wet onto the stamp set. And this is what we got. It's still a little damp. This one is going to take a while to dry because it's so big. And for this one, I used 2 sheets of paper instead of just the 1 sheet that I did with this one that you saw me make. But also the thing that I realized too is I had not yet figured out when I made this one, I had not yet figured out to use the 1 ply at a time, separate the plies. Had I done that, you would see a lot more shimmer on here because one of those plies came off.